There are moments every year that shape the spirit, capture the zeitgeist, reflect how people think and feel and act. The moments of 2022 were no different, and our creative met the moment. Through our visual GPS research, we look back on the creative visual stories of the year. A year in which we look to the future, adjusting to new norms and returning to old ones, with a newfound priority on self-care and a need to balance our work life with our personal. Representation and realness took centre stage, and we leaned into healthier routines that redefined well-being and expanded what participation looked like. What will 2023 bring? What visuals will meet the moment? Based on current research trends, we're already seeing a greater need for brands to show empathy and the life in work-life balance. Inclusion continues to grow in real life and encouragingly as a starting point in the digital conversation. And sports visuals that continue to tell an inclusive story, presenting a more diverse representation of a sports person. And there's so much more to come. Creative needs to meet the moment. Will yours in 2023? See what's trending all year long with Visual GPS research and reporting. Only from Getty Images and iStock.
On today's download, we'll tell you what our visual GPS research says about the future of work, show you what it looks like through the lenses of our contributors, and give you some regional specific insights from our expert panel. The download, presented by Getty Images, starts now. Welcome to The Download, presented by Getty Images. I'm your host, Jennifer Kelly. Thank you for joining us. As always, right up front, I want to give a special shout out to our premium access subscribers watching today. And thank you for your business. We truly appreciate it. In the latest Visual GPS report on the future of work, we ask, is your brand forward-thinking or stuck in the past? Do you align with customer and employee values? And are you showing a reflection of what work looks and feels like to today's consumers? Here to help you answer those questions and introduce our latest visual GPS findings is the author of that report, Dr. Rebecca Swift, Vice President of Creative Insights. Welcome to The Download, Rebecca.
Thank you, Jim. So the creative team here at Getty Images is constantly looking at how the visual language is evolving. And we do that through the ways that brands across the world are using imagery to talk about themselves. Right now, we are thinking and experimenting with visuals that represent what the future of work might look like. And this is pertinent because it has changed so much in the last 2 to 3 years. And within the world of work, the concept of teamwork is evolving, and the concept teamwork, especially in office-based environments, has been really significant for us as a company since we started in 1995. So we're going to look at teamwork specifically right now. It's mainly people-focused content. So although it has been represented by more conceptual, abstract ways over the years, right now we're going to look at how people within the concept of teamwork are represented. So if we go back in time, and we look at the period just after the financial crisis in the early 2010s, we'd seen a shift by brands to a depiction of corporate teamwork that was much more formal, both in dress and in the style of meeting. But importantly, teamwork was demonstrated by the work ethic of the people that were represented. So they were, busy at work in the visualization of teamwork. And the techniques that we used at that time to visualize people at work are very much represented an observational viewpoint. So it felt like the action was captured by someone involved in the meeting, which promoted the concept of transparency and trustworthiness as well. That, and those concepts were very, very important during that time because we were in a recession. And in the years leading up to the pandemic, we saw office work changing. And it was becoming more informal, both in dress and approach. And importantly, during that time, we also saw more diversity in the range of people and the roles that were being represented in our images around teamwork. We also saw the importance of sustainability showing up in business. So, and it revealed itself in the natural materials and the visibility of plants in the offices where the meetings and the teamwork was occurring. And then during the COVID pandemic, we necessarily shifted again to represent teamwork that was enabled through technology, through Zoom, through Teams, etc. So the visual language became even more informal at that time because everybody was working at home. And since the pandemic, teamwork is changing again. So some of us are back in the office, some of us are not, and we're having to represent employees that have that flexibility. And it's important to businesses to also represent that flexibility. So from our point of view, as businesses move to this more flexible or hybrid way of working, the way teamwork can be visualized has multiplied many, many times. So the big question we're trying to solve for now is, what does the future of work look like? And importantly, what does the aspiration for work in the future look like? So how will team building and team bonding be represented? How do we bring the feeling of belonging to a team in 2023 and beyond? So joining us now is Guy Merrill, our global head of art here at Getty Images. And I know he's already started working with our contributors on visualizing the future of work and also looking at answering some of these big questions.
Thanks, Rebecca, for that. Yes, I'm Guy Merrill. I work here in our London office and I manage a team of art directors who work with our photographers and filmmakers to bring in content that we know is of high value. And I wanted to talk today about a specific production. I think that is a great example of some of these ideas that Rebecca addressed. This was a big production that we put together at the end of last year in our new offices here in London, which I'm sat in right now. It was a big production with lots of models. We had 5 photographers here and filmmakers, hair stylists, you know, clothing stylists, all, you know, the works. It was definitely a big production. And we thought it was great importance because of the, you know, the changes we've seen in terms of how people are visualizing the world of work. The theme we really wanted to focus on was exploring ideas of how to visualize modern business, modern office spaces, not just as places to work, but as places to connect. So we really built that into the production in regard to what we approached and how we approached it. And we also wanted to think about not just about themes of connection, but also some of these themes that are consistently bubbling up, especially after lockdown and COVID, around wellness, support, sense of belonging and community, and as well as contemporary ideas around teamwork, which I think are really intermingled with all of those. As with any production, a lot of that thinking goes on before the shoot day. So that was really baked into our pre-production, I would say. So when we were thinking about casting for this shoot, that was something we were thinking in mind. How do we kind of demonstrate this idea of the future of work? We focused on a very diverse and slightly younger cast. We had a lot of models, which was great. We had 15. And we wanted this younger cast to kind of more accurately reflect the people who are driving this change and how the world will look. We spent a lot of time kind of crafting this story of who these models were and the people that we felt made sense in this modern office space. Like I said, slightly younger, mixed genders, a range of ethnicities and abilities. And then a huge part of that pre-production was thinking about the location. So even though we knew we were shooting within this building, we still had to make a lot of decisions around which spaces within the building made the most sense. So our creative team spent a lot of time wandering around this building, looking at the spaces and having a think about what felt the most relevant to this idea of modern office life post-COVID. And again, with this idea of connection, we really focused on those spaces where colleagues can come together in a more relaxed and connecting way. So we focused most of our time and energy with these photographers in communal areas, breakout spaces, you know, the dining area, the kitchen. We have a roof terrace here, which is great. Corridors where people may, you know, interact kind of serendipitously. And then we have a big open kind of lobby reception area. So those are the areas we really wanted to focus in, as opposed to things like conference rooms or desk areas, the kind of traditional areas that we usually would think of when we think of working, but it's actually more about these places where we can kind of come together in a personal way. And another thing we thought about quite a lot was about styling and work attire. I think in the brief, we had a phrase in there that said, the tie is dead, long live sneakers. You know, casual Fridays are a thing of the past. Every day is casual Friday. And so we wanted to, again, make really intentional choices to reflect that idea of where we are now in office attire. And these changes are subtle, but I think they make a big difference. So we looked a lot at, you know, street style when we were making the brief, the styling brief for this shoot, looking at Pinterest and looking at, you know, fashion sites, just to get a flavor of like, how do people dress for work now in, you know, 2023. So in the end, our brief really focused on comfortable clothing, relaxed clothing options that still felt office appropriate. It's not the same as what we wear at home, but it has a similar feel. So there was a lot of hoodies, a lot of denim, slouchier shapes, so like less fitted clothing, and lots and lots of sneakers. You know, I think, you know, anecdotally, I've heard from many people, including, and I know for myself, working from home all these years, our old work clothes, once we was, you know, started going back into the real world, people would put their old work clothes on and say, oh my God, these feel so restrictive now. These trousers are so tight, or these shoes are so uncomfortable, and people don't want to go back to that. And so we wanted to really factor that in terms of how that looked. And so I think you hopefully see that reflected in the imagery. So those were some of the things we were thinking about in terms of pre-production. And then on the shoot day itself, we were thinking about specific moments that we wanted to focus on. So one is obviously those moments of human connection. So more collaborative settings, more connecting spaces, and looking to convey a sense of belonging, which we know is really important to people as they kind of come back together in real life. So again, the brief really focused on a lot of those small interactions between colleagues, where people can connect on a personal level, which I think also really subtly speaks to these some of these other themes that are coming through, like around wellness and mental health, like the idea of support, right, from your work colleagues. And we thought a lot about food, interestingly, as well, which historically we had not something we would think about as being a priority in office spaces. But again, it's about these opportunities for people to come together and interact and socialize. We know that teams all around the world often make plans to come together at the same, come into the office together at the same time because of flexible working schedules and hybrid working. So they plan to come in, and that often might involve some kind of meal or outing that surrounds food. So we thought about how to incorporate those in, whether or not it's sharing time over a coffee or having lunch together. And we even did some moments that were more about kind of celebration and that sense of camaraderie. So we did some kind of like birthday celebrations in one of the dining areas with colleagues, which again, historically wouldn't have been a key moment for us to think about in kind of office life, but now it feels like it's really telling a story about that sense of connection. And then we also thought about hybrid working and how do you show that in a picture. You know, during lockdown, we spent a lot of time covering people working from home and all the varieties of what that looks like for people. And kind of overnight, we had to rethink what that means. And now we're kind of in this hybrid space, which, you know, seems to be the kind of the new normal. And so how do you show that in a picture? So we wanted to think about flexibility and office hours being more fluid. So we shot into the evening to get this sense of day to night, again, to kind of show office hours being fluid and changeable. And then other, you know, practical things, like we sourced very specifically this big Zoom screen, basically on wheels, that can be like wheeled around the office space to kind of pull off this specific idea of some people are together in real life and some people are on screen. Our creative team actually recorded themselves on a Zoom call ahead of the day so that we just had that running so that when the photographers wanted to shoot, we had this kind of pre-screened and pre-released Zoom call that we could use, and showing all of that in one image, the idea of people together in real life and people there virtually. So that's one recent production that we've worked on. There will be many more to follow, but hopefully gives you some insight into how we are thinking about visualizing work and visualizing connection and teamwork in 2023. All right. Thank you for that. Back to you, Jen.
Thank you, Guy and Rebecca. A lot of really great insights there. As you just saw, there are so many incredible, impactful images and videos on gettyimages.com, ready to bring your projects and campaigns to life. And sometimes when you find the perfect one, you want it all to yourself. That's where Market Freeze comes in. With Market Freeze, we'll temporarily remove the images or videos you want from our content library, preventing others from licensing them and allowing your projects to become uniquely yours. If you need longer-term exclusivity, we do full buyouts as well. Speak to your Getty Images representative to see if Market Freeze is the right solution for you. We'll be back right after this. Whether you're creating a brand from scratch or evolving and maintaining an existing one, there are any number of challenges you're going to face.
Your ultimate priority in brand management, especially brand asset management, should be to create and maintain consistency. How will you ensure brand assets such as logos, color palettes, icons, and photography are used for their intended brand? How will you share out all of your approved brand assets?
Now that you've seen what the future of work looks like, let's show you how to find it. It's the fastest 5 minutes in search.
Thanks, Jen. Hi, I'm Chris Perez Iniguez, Senior Research Editor on Getty's Global Research Team. I'm here to share some tips and tricks on how to find future of work content on our site. A successful search revolves around keywords, because as culture evolves, so does our vocabulary used to describe it. Let's reverse engineer a search and begin with the board of recent work-related content that Guy just shared with us. For the fastest and most reliable way to finding keywords that are unique and relevant to your subject and also up to current cultural trends, whether in our stills or video collection, look no further than the ADP. By clicking into any asset, you can scroll down to the bottom of the page and find a cluster of keywords unique to this asset. Use this as you would a thesaurus for alternate takes on a subject, and combine both conceptual and descriptive tags for your own customized search. Looking closer, this asset contains a few tags that describe the future hybrid work wellness qualities discussed earlier in the show. For example, here we have new business, well-being, brainstorming, togetherness, employee engagement, teamwork, diversity, transgender, creativity, communication, business casual, etc., among many other great options. You see, from this one asset alone, we can gather a variety of tags to begin a new search. Video assets also contain tags in their ADP as well. Let's open up this video asset right here into a new tab. Scroll to the bottom. And you see here we have togetherness, business casual, bonding, partnership, teamwork, party, social event, multiracial group, social inclusion, even a keyword called the way forward. So whether you're starting a new search or feeling overwhelmed and need some keyword inspiration, find an image that you like, check out the tags in its ADP, and begin from there. Now that we've noted some essential keywords and are ready to begin a search in our search bar, it's just as important to be cognizant of how you are combining multiple keywords in a search string. Let me show you what I mean. Using the conjunctions and, or not between keywords modifies our search string. We have a way of controlling what we see in the results. This is known as Boolean. For example, if we want all of our results to contain the same exact keywords, we can use the Boolean operator and, use a comma, or simply leave a space between keywords. For example, new business and well-being and brainstorming. Click enter. You see that we have 241 images returned, and we can continue adding to this string using the operator and, togetherness, and diversity. Click enter. And as you can see, we've gone down a few images to about 22 results. Now, if we were to go through the ADP of each one of these assets, we'll find that all of them contain the keywords that we used up here in the search bar. If we want a wider range of options while using the operator and, simply limit the number of keywords that you use. For example, get rid of a few of these keywords and just leave new business and well-being. Click enter. And as you can see, our results have jumped up to about 4,600. Now, if we want results containing at least one of the keywords present in your string, use the Boolean operator or between them. For example, switch this and out for an or. Click enter. And now notice that our results have jumped up significantly to almost 4 million. This is because using the operator or allows you to cast a wider net. This is helpful when you want to search keywords that embody similar concepts, but you don't need all of them tagged within a single image. For example, new business and brainstorming and wellness or mental health or healthy lifestyle. And there you have it. Lastly, the Boolean operator not removes any of the keywords that you don't want showing up in your results. For example, teamwork and business and small business, not corporate. Click enter. And we can continue to remove items that we don't want in our results. For example, not close up and not looking at camera. So experiment with using all three Boolean terms together in your search string to shape your visual field and to control the amount of images that you want to sift through. In the next segment, we'll be talking about some region-specific content. Open up the filters panel and scroll to the bottom where we have a tab for locations. Click into this, and immediately you'll find prominent countries and regions for your search topic, which will appear here first. But you can also click into See More Locations to explore many others. And that's the fastest 5 minutes of search. Make sure you check out the list of my favorite keywords related to the future of work in the YouTube description and also on the show page. Now, back to you, Jen.
Thanks, Chris. Great tips. Rebecca returns to lead our regional panel discussion right after this.
So following on from my chat with Guy Merrill, I'm now going to continue the conversation about what the future work looks like by bringing in the regional creative insights leads from Getty Images. First of all, I'd like to introduce you to Kate Rook, who covers our Asia Pacific region, Jacqueline Burke, who covers our Europe and Middle East region, and Tristan Norman, who covers the Americas. So we've already discussed the changes in the way that teamwork looks and what we are creating to match the needs of our potential future business. But now let's instead discuss how businesses might be using visuals to attract and retain their talent in the future. So thinking more about their employees. We all saw the great resignation of last year, and we saw that as an indication of the shifts in the priorities of workers or employees. And in our own data, we saw quiet quitting as a globally trending new search term. So connected to that, our visual GPS research also found that almost a 3/4 of workers are now prioritizing the balance between their work and personal lives since the pandemic. So what I'm going to ask the team now is, are you seeing that focus on work-life balance across your regions? I'm going to come to you first, Kate.
Yeah, so in Asia Pacific, actually very similar, Rebecca, to what you're seeing globally, with Japan being even higher than what we're seeing globally. So 85% of Japanese consumers said that they are looking to achieve better work-life balance. Is that the same in Europe and the Middle East, Jacqueline?
Yeah, it's quite similar. Funny enough, Kate, very similar to Japanese consumers. When we look across all the countries in Europe, it's actually the French consumers who are more likely to agree that achieving that very important better work-life balance is a top priority for them. So not quite as high as Japanese consumers, but we are talking about 80% of French consumers. And I think that's quite interesting if you think about the fact that as early as 2013, France was the first country to legalize the right to disconnect. And obviously, we've seen across Europe, more European countries have followed suit. But if we look then, for instance, across to the Middle East and to consumers in the United Arab Emirates, we do find that this is less of a priority. So we're genuinely talking about only 53% of consumers in the United Arab Emirates who agree that achieving a better balance between work life and their personal life has become more of a priority. So Tristan, would be very interested to see what's happening in your region and if there's any key differences across the markets there.
Thanks, Jackie. I mean, in the Americas, it's a little bit more complicated than that. Work-life balance is certainly a priority, but it has a distinct nuance in different parts of the region. So for example, in the US, what we find is that while the majority of consumers do want work-life balance, we also find that there is actually an 11-point drop when asked that same question about whether or not it's a priority now versus pre-pandemic. What the reality actually reveals for us is that there is this awareness for a need for balance and even the need for a life lived well, but there's less of a desire in the US for it to come at the expense of financial success, stability, or their savings, which are all key areas of their life focus. But when you pop down to Spanish-speaking Latin America, what we find is that work-life balance becomes a little bit more of a given, and those numbers sort of stabilize in comparison to the rest of the world. What we also, though, find that it's kind of beside the point. You know, Latin Americans are actually prioritizing their job and their career and having one that they feel passionate about at a rate that is higher than most of the world post-pandemic. And we're finding that pretty consistently also in Brazil as well, where financial security, job or career success is existing alongside work-life balance. So this indicates for us that nearly all of Americas are trying to find a way to be successful without sacrificing too much of their health and well-being.
So it seems that across the world, we are seeing work-life balance and the need to balance success and health as being important. And I think that's something that we need to really focus on going forward. The other interesting data point that that we discovered in the last survey that we ran was that 2/3 of workers believe they are more productive when they're working at home. But at the same time, more, so 8 out of 10, 80%, said that they would like to be in the office at least part of the time, which again is really talking to productivity versus sociability. Is this an indication of what work-life balance might look in the future, do you think? And Tristan, I'm going to come to you first.
Yeah, that's an excellent, excellent question. You know, Rebecca, when we talk about moving from old ways of working into new, in the Americas, you find a story that's kind of, again, a little bit complicated by our very messy, very unstable post-pandemic reality. You know, in the US in particular, what is happening is the pendulum is swinging back again to this desire to working more remotely and working more flexibly. There is more of an emphasis on a type of flexibility that is employee-led. There's an increased desire for hybrid options where folks decide for themselves how they work. But when you pop down to Latin America, what's interesting enough, interesting for that part of the world is that, you know, there's actually a more of an increase of a desire to work exclusively in the office. And in fact, a minor decline, a very teensy decline, but a notable decline in the desire for working full time. And I think that is being driven by the culture in Latin America, this desire for community and connection. And in fact, there are a much higher rate of being eager to resume regular in-person interactions. At the same time, in Brazil, again, really complex and a little bit different. There is a more of a decline for desire to work exclusively in the office and more of an interest in hybrid working options, but they want their hybrid options to be set by the company. And they feel very strongly that their quality of life will decline if they don't have that hybrid option available to them. So to be honest, it's not that straightforward of a story and really underscores the need for thinking about these regional nuances when it comes to the future of work. So Kate, are you finding similar complexities in the Asia-Pacific region?
So I'd say, Tristan, for us on average across Asia-Pacific, our visual GPS research found that 80%+ believe companies should offer hybrid work options. And then we found an almost 50-50 split saying that they were more productive when they work from home. And again, very similar to what we're seeing in some of the other regions, that social interaction and that connection is what is being missed. So they miss that connection with their colleagues and that social interaction. And we found this was particularly strong for Southeast Asia. So I'd say visually the lines to some degree have blurred between work and home life. And for the future of work, I truly believe it will be less about showing somebody on a laptop working from home. This has continued to be popular since COVID in Asia Pacific. Again, strongest, I'd say, in Australasia. And I'd say it's more about showing the balance in our lives. So it could be as simple as shopping or running your errands in the middle of the day when it's noticeably less busier or noticeably a different time of day, sunnier or lighter, for example, or picking up your kids from school. Jacqueline, are you seeing similarities in Europe and the Middle East to what we're seeing in the Americas and Asia Pacific?
Yeah, I can pick on two very strong points there. First of all, Kate, like Southeast Asia, Europeans are evenly split about whether they feel like they're more productive at home. So if we look across, for example, Germany, it's about 51%, France about 55%, Nordics 54%, so they're all in that range. So what was interesting for us to understand here in Europe was, well, will they embrace a hybrid working model given that split? So we found that it was UK consumers in particular who are least likely to want to embrace a hybrid model. So we're talking about 47%, or we're seeing Nordic consumers in particular are indexing higher at 62%. So they're much more open to this, you know, preferred hybrid model. But overall, picking up on a point, Tristan, you brought up around Latin American consumers, we do find for French consumers in particular, given the fact that they have the right to legally disconnect, 9 in 10 French consumers prefer to work in the office, even if it's at least part-time. And then overall, picking up on both your points, we do see for Europeans in general, 6 in 10 genuinely miss social interaction and the connection that comes with working in the office. And if we look at it across age group, quite interestingly, it over-indexes the highest for the youngest generation we surveyed, which was Generation Z. So when we look around at some other independent research here in Europe, we do find that research studies show that while hybrid work does boost short-term productivity, it can also diminish long-term creativity and that all-important connection. So I think in visuals will play an important part in really showing how we're going to move forward the future of work. And I think it'll quite simply shift from showing connectivity to actually showing connection in all of its forms.
And going back to the media coverage of the Great Resignation, which was seen as a result of a lot of what you've all been talking about. You know, I mean, we saw very quickly twice as much interest by brands on visualizing employee appreciation, which is a slightly different angle on the need to show how a business relates or connects with their own employees. So how do we show that employees are working in a way that suits them best? You know, relating to what you've all just said, and how do we show that businesses and business leaders actually care? And I think care is a really important word about the people who work for them. And I'm going to go back to you first, Jacqueline, because I'd like to hear what's happening in Europe.
Okay, well, I think there's some really great points there. They're very topical in the conversations we're having with customers in Europe right now. I think there has, in a very broad sweeping statement, there has been a sense that all brands must now be wellness brands. And our research shows very strongly that consumers across Europe, they do care about how brands care for their employees. So it's quite an important topic, Rebecca, to really understand how do we visualize employee appreciation. And the biggest shift we've seen in the visuals our customers in Europe are engaging with, so what's quite popular with them in the last 12 months, really centers around how do you show teamwork and how do you show a greater sense of workplace wellness. So it's less about showing people doing the actual work to showing how people are interacting within the workplaces, whether that's in their traditional office or in warehouses or, you know, factories or whether it's at home. And then it's less also about showing success as career advancement to showing success as really belonging and creating a caring and inclusive culture. So you can see this clearly in the themes around teamwork. So visually, it's either through supporting each other, enjoying each other's company while at work or taking a break. I think it also comes down to that less, you know, formality, whether it's around the clothes that people are seen to wear. You know, again, it's about that blending between the workplace and home. It's about the body language. And for me, what's been most interesting is seeing the rise around more caring moments through the body language. You know, we're talking about mentorship moments between colleagues, very much leaning in towards each other with that sense of proactive listening rather than excitedly in a very vibrant brainstorm, for instance. But Tristan, interesting to pick up given what you shared with us so far around how important success is within the US market in particular. What are you seeing there?
Yeah, thanks, Jacqueline. So, I mean, we're at a really, really interesting inflection point that sort of underscores that the only constant in our lives is change. In the Americas, you know, what we're finding is if you go into 2021, we see exactly what you're talking about when it comes to that less formality, that kind of blending of our lives of home and work lives and also caring for children and also doing your interests and doing your hobbies. You also see that in terms of the aesthetic choices where the color palette sort of really warms up and disrupts the aesthetics of typical business visuals. So you'll see oranges and purples and yellows and greens in favor of blues and grays and whites and beiges, you know, and that sort of uniformity. But what's also happening, which is really interesting, that we see happen quite a bit when it comes to businesses as we go through these kind of cycles of change, is that in 2022, we're kind of seeing a little bit of that sharp return to formality. You know, there's still that peaks of that more human, more flexible, more casual work, but there is a more of an emphasis, I think, as things have stabilized, to Rebecca's point about the Great Resignation, that there's return to, you know, our IRL working style, in-person collaboration, which, yes, underscores teamwork, but also goes back and kind of retreats back to this type of aesthetic where you get those blues, you get that more formality back into business visuals. And this stands a little bit in contrast to what consumers in this part of the world actually desire seeing. There is still this need to reflect a more casual working environment. people responded really well in North America to imagery focused on a sort of traveling while working, or imagery showing people's personalities in their homes while working. And so we need to make sure that we are not returning to where we feel most comfortable just because of, you know, the current environment, the current crisis we're in, because that's not necessarily what consumers desire in the Americas. Kate, I don't know if there's a similar dynamic that's happening, but I'd love to hear what you think about that.
Yeah, so it's really interesting listening to both of you, because actually for Asia Pacific, I'd say there are many similarities with what you, Jacqueline, said and you, Tristan. So in Australasia, there has been a shift in businesses also looking to show teamwork, Jackie, that you, Jacqueline, you picked up on, but through much bigger groups of colleagues either huddled together or collaborating together, something that we're not seeing as strongly in other countries in Asia Pacific. And our image testing across the region found similar findings to your region, Tristan, where showing the flexibility of being able to work anywhere in the world or any place, whether outdoors, close to nature, or traveling whilst working, was also very appealing.
Right, I'm going to ask you one final question, and I just want a single line answer from each of you. What are you expecting the future of work to look like?
Single line, it's very difficult in this work we do. The future of work is, I believe, self-actualized, that we are able to be our full and whole selves through the work we do and still be successful. And that is what needs to be represented in visuals.
I'm going to say specifically because Asia Pacific is the fastest aging region in the world, to just really think about who are the people that we're visualizing in this flexible working environment, and not to forget the older demographics in those concepts around flexibility, teamwork, connection, and that casualness in the workplace.
For myself, in Europe, I would say we'll see a visual shift from burnout to balance. I'll put that emphasis on workplace wellness, because we've genuinely seen that Europeans are experiencing burnout more than ever before. So where we see that workplace wellness, embracing flexibility and fluidity and all the modes and environments of work, it'll be very exciting to see where we're going to shift to.
Thank you. You all stretched the definition of a single sentence there, but thank you for your responses. And thank you so much for having this conversation. It's always fun and enlightening having these chats about what's going on regionally versus globally. And, you know, we know that the flexible or hybrid working model is blurring the line between work and life. And as you can probably tell, we're working through how to represent how work might look in the future. But importantly, how that might vary from region to region. So if you'd like to learn more, please go to visualgps.com. But for now, I'm going to hand you back to Jen.
Well, that is all the time that we have for today. Special thanks to our guests, Rebecca, Guy, Tristan, Jacqueline, Kate, and Chris. Don't forget that you can watch all of our past episodes over on the Getty Images events page anytime on demand. And for more of the latest trends, head on over to visualgps.com for the latest Visual GPS research and reporting from our visual experts. Thanks again for joining us today. I've been your host, Jennifer Kelly, and we'll see you next time on The Download. Thank you.